Shooting the film was very, you know, for my first movie, I wanted to experience something that I've never experienced before. And that's exactly what happened here. The group of guys, mga naka-work ko, sobrang naging close po kami on set, and I can't imagine spending it with a different group of guys. Lahat ng mga nakikita nyo on-cam, yung mga chemistry namin, bonding namin as a barkada, kinagawa rin namin off-cam. So, of course, directed by Joey Reyes, such an honor. And being able to work with people like Kisses, Devon, Sophia, Jane, the whole cast was very fun. And especially the ones you don't see on cam, yung mga cameraman, staff, they really set the tone for the entire environment. Kasi, opo, lahat kami millennials actually. No, like, even the cameramen, even the interns, they are interns of direct. So, not just that, but the script writer, the one who wrote the entire movie, is a millennial. He's 19 years old. So, it's just so fun. It's just really, really fun. I wish I could relive it again.
So, parang naging reality.
Yeah, it really did.
Anyway, ito, can you tell us something about your character?
Si Bobby Fernandez. Kumbaga ako po yung eye ng squad. Kasi mata. Lahat ng ginagawa namin, lahat ng memories namin, kunyari lalabas kami, nandun yun, naka-record yung camera. So, everything that we go through, I have my camera. And my dream is to be the next Brillante Mendoza. And may time sa movie na may mga katotoo lang sa akin, parang sinasabi nila sa akin na hindi mo kayang gawin yun. Kasi mahirap yun. Tsaka yung filmmaking, seryosong bagay yun. Yes, so I have to prove to everyone that this is really what I wanna do and that I can do it.
Ano ba sa role mo sa film? Nakarelate ka ba somehow?
Yes po, dun sa aspect na gusto kong gawin yung bagay na kahit may mga tao na nagsasabi sa'yo na hindi mo kaya, you know, I know deep inside that I can do it. And you have to always fight for what you believe in. And si Bobby kasi never siya nag-give up eh. Yung lahat ng bagay na parang pwede siya mag-give up pero hindi siya talaga. He's the guy who just keeps pursuing it and he just sticks to his goal in life, which is to be the next Brillante Mendoza.
So,
bale,
parang sa part ng life lessons ka, mas nakakalagay sa dream niya, or may...
Well, you know, interestingly enough, kasi napanood ko yung mga movies na pinag-usapan namin sa mga scenes namin eh. So, we talked about really old movies. And of course, I had to know the movies in order to, you know, para alam ko talaga sa scene, diba? So, I got really interested. There's so many movies out there, especially during the old times, na sobrang interesting talaga. And mga VHS tapes pa, grabe.
May feeling
na, nagpa-play ng mga VHS tapes compared to, ngayon, diba, online na lahat. But before, the world was very different. And it was very different for our parents. When Direct Joey just started, it was very different. So, I got really interested in film. And you know, maybe who knows? Because right now I'm in film, but as an actor, so we'll never know. But I'm really opening my doors, yes. I'm very interested.
And then, how was your role related to Kisses?
My role related to Kisses' role? Bobby loves film, and so does Ruby. So, yun yung reason kung bakit sila nag-click kasi parehas silang weird. We're both weird, pero mas weird si Ruby. Kasi hindi ako nagwi-wig na cosplay. Bad joke lang, pero seryoso. We both love film. We both have the same interests and we both believe that you don't have to focus on other people's opinions about it. Kasi usually sa buhay, we're so caught up in like what others think of ourselves. But Ruby and Bobby, they're their own people and they believe in themselves and they could care less about what people say. Challenges. Siguro sa yung pinakauna yung getting in the the filmmaker mindset. I really had to I really had to make sure na si Bobby Fernandez na pinaplay ko ay talagang si Bobby Fernandez, like the way the scriptwriter wanted it to be. So, well, I'm not really that, how do you call it? I'm not really that aware of the old movies before. As in, hindi ako yung parang sobrang, ano ba? I'm not the one who's really interested in the old movies before. Until now. Like, sobrang, ano eh, yung sobrang old talaga. So, that was, I think, it. But in general, Direct Joey made it so easy for us to shoot. Sobrang open niya. Kunyari, may gusto kaming gawin. May gusto kaming mag-gawin sa script. Sabihin na, in a millennial way, he'll let us do it. And before we started the movie, he told all of us that if you want to change the way a phrase or sentence was written in order to match what millennials think, then do it. You have the freedom. So during the set, ganun rin siya. He's very hands-on, but he gives us space. So it made it very, so much more easier for us.
So after the challenges, ano naman yung learnings na sugarin mo dito sa making the movie na to? From the story to shooting?
Real life lessons. I think what I could learn from this, even the movie itself, you really have to choose a good group of friends. Kasi, alam naman natin yung quote na you are who you hang out with, you are who your friends are. Kasi doon mo makikita kung sino ba talaga yung personality, ano ba talaga ang personality mo from your friends. Yeah, they influence you. And they're there for your problems. They're there when you need someone to get advice from. So I learned that you could get these group of friends anywhere because it can happen anytime. I never knew that I would get this close to these group of people. And things in life can happen spontaneously. So that's the biggest one.
Based naman dito sa title, so Walwal, meron ka bang Walwal experience?
Walwal experience.
Can you share it with us?
Can you share it with us? Hindi naman talagang walwal na all out, but we went out with the boys. Actually, not really out, but parang nag-chill lang kami.
Social drinking.
Yeah, social. Kasi, I think it was important for all of us to see each other, not just on set, but outside as well. Kasi,
wait. Sorry guys, I have to interrupt this. I have a special
announcement.
This is the
poster. Are you ready? Go. Bro!
But no. Ain't this jiggy?
That's so cool.
Ain't this dope?
Mike says.
But again, ain't this dope?
Yo, that's so savage.
Ain't this dope? Hey, you gotta do this.
Ayun, so parang gano'n na-imagine nyo na kung bakit sila nagsosocial drinking.
Oo nga po eh. Si Jerome yung advisor namin.
Advisor talaga.
Parang sa'yo nagbibigay ng advice. Pero
based on experiences.
Yeah, and
it's actually a miracle. Like, how he is.
Yeah, I think it was very important for us to see each other, not just on the set, but outside as well. Para ma-build on talaga yung chemistry namin. Yeah, and so that you'll see in real life. You'll see in the movie na ganun talaga kami in real life. And yung acting namin magiging mas authentic. So, yeah.
So, anong gusto mong ma-import sa kabataan ngayon? Sa mga ka-age natin?
About the movie? Or from the movie itself? That,
our life experiences.
Well, for those who are, I think the biggest misconception is people who, yeah, nagwawalwal or mga ganun.
I don't see myself.
Parang, it's always like a bad thing. People are always doing it just to, you know, get drunk, get wasted. But there are times when teenagers like us, we just wanna, it's good to enjoy sometimes. And it's good to have a good time. But you have to know your limits. Always know your limits. Always know when to say no. And understand that sa lahat ng mga ginagawa mo, may mga consequences yan, may mga parang effects yan. So always be cautious of that and aware of what you do.
Yeah. Ito naman, kasi graduate lang ng sister mo. So, ito naman, outside the movie. kagaya ng sister mo, may plan din ba siya para mag-social base? Or na-share niya ba sa'yo na parang gusto mo yung ginagawa mo, or may nakikita ko ba sa kanya?
Kaya right now, nakasign niya lang with Universal. So, I think she's always wanted to expose herself na ganun. Pero ngayon, focus niya talaga yung YouTube. I don't know if she wants to pursue acting, but magaling siya umarte. Pero English ha. She can speak Tagalog, but I think she can work on it. But she's a really good actress. She was the lead in her play sa high school for Legally Blonde. So, magaling siya kumanta, kumarte, sumayaw. So, I'm very proud of her. She graduated with a 4.0. Sorry, I'm just bragging. She graduated with a 4.0. That's Bishop Award. That's like a perfect almost. So, straight A's. It is a perfect. It's a perfect. Straight A's. My sister got straight A's. As a senior in an international school, that's very hard. And she did that while still being able to have a YouTube channel. She was working, you know, going to these events. So I'm very proud of my sister. And let's see. Let's see what happens in the future. But she's very done.
Ito naman this year, mag-start ka na ba sa UT?
Nag-start na po ako.
So paano nag-ready? Preparation?
Well, obviously, nag-tutor ako. Or we studied a lot for the exam. I took the UGAT. It's called the UGAT. Or UGAT for Open University online courses. And we just started like 2 weeks ago. So,
kamusta naman so far?
Okay naman. Siguro yung part na ngayon kasi 2 weeks pa lang eh. So this part is like getting to know each other, parang introducing the topics. So we'll see what happens in the next couple of months.
Ayan.
Doon ko talaga makikita kung yung talagang time management na sinasabi ng daddy.
Ayan, so anong plano mo? Last question ito. Anong plano mo? Paano mo ipabalance yung work mo at yung studies?
Time management is the biggest factor here. Yung mga priorities sa buhay mo, you have to know when to say no to things that might not benefit you. It's easier said than done. I'm actually, sometimes there are also times where, you know, kung game kami. Kung game ako. Pero nakakalimutan natin yung mga responsibilities natin. Just like in the movie, in Walwal. It happens for everyone, but it's important to learn from it. So time management is really key. And anything's possible through Christ. Yeah. Thank you so much, guys.